Before you start this setup installation guide, we're making the assumption that you have Python installed. If you don't, then check out the previous tutorial where we take you through those steps. In this course, our preferred code editor is Visual Studio Code. All the examples in this course will be presented utilizing this software. Although it's completely optional what code editor you choose, we do recommend that you follow along with this course with Visual Studio Code. So let's start by browsing or searching for Visual Studio Code. We can use the keyword download as well. That can be handy. That should take us to code.visualstudio.com download. So let's go over to that webpage. Looks a little bit like this. Okay, accept that. So from here, you can see that we've got multiple options. Visual Studio Code can be installed and used on multiple operating systems. Now, assuming that you have a computer that's been purchased over the last 10 years, the likelihood is that you're running a 64-bit operating system. So you can select the 64-bit setup installer here, this 64-bit option here, or you can just go ahead and select this Windows download. Whichever one you decide, that should be absolutely fine. So this download here is going to be a universal installer for Windows 8, 10, and 11. Okay, so I'm clicking on that page. You can see that we've started downloading. So that'll take a couple of seconds and then we can start. So let's quickly run through the installation wizard here. So accept the agreement, press next. You can decide where you want to install Visual Studio Code. I don't recommend that you change the installation settings there unless you have some specific setup on your computer. So just next, the start menu folder, just next. And then let's create a desktop icon that can be handy. And add to path, that is always going to be handy. So we can utilize the terminal effectively. Let's press next and install. Once you've finished installing Visual Studio Code, go ahead and open up Visual Studio Code. I'm just going to take you through a few different settings that you can apply and give you a basic introduction to Visual Studio Code if you're completely new to this. So first of all, we need to select what we want it to look like. So I'm just going to select the dark option here. Next selection here. There isn't really anything here that we need to consider. So let's just close that tab. Right, so first of all, if we want to create a new project with Visual Studio Code, or if you want to work with the project, then we generally open up the folder and work within that folder. So what we're going to need to do here, very briefly, is let's go over to a desktop here. Let's just create a new folder. Let's just call this project. So generally you have a project folder. That's the folder where your project is being developed. All the files, etc., is going to be in that folder. So generally when we open up a new Visual Studio Code window or project, the first step is to open the folder. We can do that by the left-hand side here. We have the Explorer tab here, or you can go to File and then Open Folder. So we just need to select the folder, our project folder, and now we have the project folder on the left-hand side here. So we're interacting with that folder we just created on the desktop. So if we were to create a new file, so all Python files have the .py file extension, you can see we created a new file there. So if I go back to the folder we created on the desktop, you can see that that folder now has that file we've just created. So you can see how that's interacting with that folder. Right, so that's my project. And the idea here is that we click on the file. It appears on the right-hand side here. We can start writing some code. You can see that Visual Studio Code uses a tab system. So when we open up new files, you'll be able to access those files from the top ribbon here. So on the right-hand side, this can be pretty handy. Here we can split the screen so you can work on two files. That's pretty handy if you're working with multiple files. And we can close that. So go ahead and close the file. That will then close that additional window. So you'll notice here, I know it's very small at the moment, or maybe on your screen, but you can see a dot next to the name with the file that we've opened. That dot represents the fact that the file has not been saved. Now, one of the common problems that I find students fall into at the start is they forget to save their files. Now, I recommend that you go over to File and you select Auto Save. So just click on Auto Save and that will just auto save now all the files. So you'd never have to press Save. Anytime you type something, it will just automatically save. And that can be really handy. Something else that you'll probably want to do is to zoom in or utilize the wheel mouse to zoom in. So if you go over to File and then Preferences and then Settings, that's where you're going to find all the settings for Visual Studio Code. But if I type in zoom into this search bar up the top here, I can select zoom. And now what I can do is I can easily zoom when holding the control key and my mouse. If I can find the control key, of course, there we go. So there we go. So it makes it a lot easier for you to zoom in and out, which can be very handy. In addition to that, if you hold down control and press plus and minus on your keyboard, you can actually scale the whole UI of Visual Studio Code. The last feature which is going to be utilized on this course is the terminal. Now, if I drag from the bottom, just before the blue bar at the bottom, you can't see that, but you can kind of see where my mouse is ended here. Just here, the new arrow appears, up and down arrow appears when it's available. And it means I can drag up and I can drag this terminal up with my mouse here. So this opens up the terminal. This is a really handy feature that we're going to be utilizing throughout this course. And generally when you're working with Django or Python, the terminal is normally needed for some reason. So I can access that terminal by dragging up. Now there is a shortcut. If I go to view, you can see here we're told in the terminal I need to press Control plus and it looks like a left single quote. That is a shortcut to bring the terminal up and down. So Control plus, I don't think I have it on this keyboard. I'm using a Mac keyboard. No, it's not going to work. Okay, so on your keyboard you can type in your shortcut. Now let me just zoom back out again. Okay, so if you do want to remove the terminal, there is a bin here, which I click, and then that removes the terminal and closes the terminal window. So just make sure that you feel comfortable opening and closing the terminal, whether you drag or whether you use the shortcut. I do recommend that you spend maybe 5-10 minutes just familiarizing yourself with Visual Studio Code, because it can make following the tutorials much easier.